Hey everyone, it's Rock for Cash, People's Champ, coming to you live from Cash Stadium. And what a week of FNFL it has been, week 12. Few upsets, one game in particular, just absolutely amazing outcome, but we'll go into that in a little bit more detail in a little while. As we always do on a weekly basis, we thank Team Mazza for their song this week. This is, I think, by Simon Garfunkel, Hello Darkness, My Old Friend. It's a bit of a song that Maz has put out in ode to his team's efforts this week. So we'll just have that playing in the background as we go through what's actually happened this week in week 12. In the first game, the Cash talked about it last week. Was Rock for Cash hosting Team Mazza. The Cash was very worried about this game. Half his team was out on a bye, but he still had a little bit of faith in the team that had brought in the second stringers, that they would get over the top, and by fuck did they get over the top, beating the fast... The team that was the hottest team in the FNFL, Team Mazza, no longer, just a little fizzer now. As I said in the last Cash, the Cash is the hottest team in the FNFL. The Cash winning 94.62 to Team Mazza 89.14. In the game here, look, there were a few great standouts for the Cash. Juju got 24.9, a 97-yard touchdown. Thank you very much. Tyler Boyd, 14. Ridley, 13. Gronk, 11. Vinatieri, 10. As Maz has told me over and over again, Ridley, Gronk, Boyd only got touchdowns this week. They haven't had many touchdowns through the year. They just fired up against his team. But like I said, we set ourselves for this match. We were 9 losses, 2 wins going in against Team Mazza in this game. Lost earlier to them this season by a few points, so we really wanted to turn things around, and by fuck we did. For Team Mazza, Breeze had 19, Melvin Gordon 18.6. Cash was absolutely ecstatic when Melvin Gordon, who's now out for 2 to 4 weeks, went off the ground halfway through the second quarter. He had 18 points already halfway through the second quarter. So the Cash was a little bit worried this guy was going to go absolutely apeshit, but no, it was great to see him get injured. Aaron Jones, 15, and Chris Carson, 12.3. The Cash has just got a little bit for you here. A few things has come across his desk in the last couple of days. Cash has not been doing any interviews, but he's been busy having a read of the Cash shit rag, as you can see there. Team Mazza derailed by the Cash is a photo of the Team Mazza train, absolutely bent, just no good anymore. The Cash has been fielding calls all day from Hollywood producers. They really want to try and turn this particular game into a movie, maybe a mini series, TV series, who knows. Cash is just working out the details at the moment, but there's a few ideas that they've sort of run past me at this stage, and I'm not really sure which way to go with it, so I might put a poll on the FNFL page. But a few of the ideas is, as you can see here, is a picture of Mazza, the train, absolutely rooted there. The Mazza train disaster. So, as you can see there, not too good for Team Mazza. That's one idea they're floating by the Cash. The next one, great picture here, just called Bent Over. It's what happened to Team Mazza this week by the Cash. Just bent them over and gave them a good rogering. Or thirdly, picture of a girl, as is what Team Mazza's team is, a bunch of girls with the team, with the name of this particular movie or TV series, Stop Hurting Me. Like I said, Cash is going to work through these. His main one at the moment, he thinks he's going to run with, is probably Stop Hurting Me. It was clear through the game that the Cash was just too strong and just kept pounding against Team Mazza to the point where they just inconsolable and rocking in a corner. But yeah, you know, great win by the Cash. So in the next game, not really much in this one. The Browns train, this train hasn't been derailed. This train is absolutely flying at the moment. 118.34 against Little Waiters, 66.36. No, never close this game. The Browns, McCaffrey got 35, Cam Newton 22, Elliott 20, and the Chargers defense 10. For Little Waiters, Russell Wilson got 19. He's in a bit of a vein of form at the moment. Julio 12.8, another great game by him. And 10 points to Justin Tucker. But like I said, no one ever came close to this, and the Browns were just too good in this game. So well done, the King Brown Snake. In the next game, again, another shellacking. Archie's All-Stars this time. They travelled over to Lara at Little River Giants Stadium. Little River Giants Stadium should have just stayed in bed, the boys, because this was Archie's All-Stars and Father Cull, 123.74. Little River Giants, 58.38. Fuck, 58. How do you score 58 in this day and age? But anyway, this is what they've done. Archie's All-Stars just led beautifully across the board. Fournette, 22.8. Shame that he won't be playing this next week, being suspended for a week. That'll hurt Father Cull. Thielen got 18, Davis got 19, Ertz got 15, Wentz got 10, Cook got 13, the Texans got 12. There's just people everywhere in this game. For Little River Giants, not too many standouts. Roethlisberger got 18, Barber got 12, and the Cowboys defense got 11. But yeah, this just turned out to be an absolute shellacking in the end. So well done, Father Cull. In the next game, Moneymakers 7 travelled over to Kelpie Stadium. And if you go back and have a look, the Cash did tip this one. It was 10th versus, I think it was 11th versus 5th or something. But the Cash tipped the Moneymakers. The Moneymakers have this habit of winning these sort of games where they're not expected to win, these little upsets. But yeah, 126.58 to 93.32. Moneymakers were led by Barkley with 26.2, Jameis Winston 21, Mixon 15, Diggs 14, Adams 16, Joku 12. For the Kelpies, Andrew Luck had 21, Brady got 14, and Tyler Lockett 16. But again, this wasn't close. Kelpies were pretty much playing catch-up all game. Moneymakers got out to a good lead and pretty much held it. So well done, Mickety. A win you probably really needed. In the next game, this is the Oh My Fucking God What Happened Cup, I'm calling this one. Shiva Kamini hosting Mitch's Mongrels, and Shiva Kamini, who couldn't fucking beat an egg before this game, scored 107.52 to the fast-finishing Mitch's Mongrels, 92.7. Min will be fucking spewing in this one because everyone's been beating Nickety, I should say, and he just couldn't get the chocolates this week. Shiva Kamini, I mean, he's just pulled a massive upset here. Probably upset of the season, really, if you think about it. LeGarrant Blount, who couldn't rush to save himself. He scores 22.3, has two rushing touchdowns. Hasn't played that well since he was at the Patriots about 5 years ago. Eric Ebron 16, Edelman 14, Brady 19. So you can see the Bears 16. You can see the Patriots led this pretty much as a win for Nickety. For Mitch's Mongrels, Deshaun Watson today, I think he needed something like 40 or 41. He got 25. Mike Evans got 11. Odell Beckham got 10. And the Saints defense got 18. But in the end, Nickety, too good against Mitch's Mongrels. He'll be spewing about this one. This is a game that they would have just penciled in. Looking forward to next week. But Yeah, it looks like that you just can't take anyone for granted anymore in the FNFL. I mean, there's a few upsets this week already. You just need to be off by 1 or 2% and you'll get beaten. Like I say, the FNFL, she's a cruel bitch. Every time you think you've worked her out, she comes up with something else that just out of left field, and you just stand there with your mouth open and your dick in your hand thinking, how the hell did that happen? In the final game, again, this was the closest game. Well, actually not the closest, second closest game of the round. It got close today, though. Smooth Criminal traveled to Young Remix Killers Stadium, wherever that is. I hear that this might have been played on the corner of Burke and Elizabeth Street in the city. We're not sure where his stadium is. But the Young Remix Killers got the chocolates here, 97.38 to Smooth Criminal 90.28. Today, Fairburn from the Texans, the kicker, he scored 12. Smooth Criminal had some cockhead wide receiver called Cootie, who got 1.4, and that pretty much was the difference in this game. You know, she needed Cooties to get the Cooties going, and the Cooties did fuck all. So I'm tipping that the Cooties will be given the arse this week, and possibly a good idea to have had Amari Cooper, who was sitting on her bench with 30 points, and Lamar Miller, who had 22.7. But in saying that, this week's Taco Bell went to Young Remix Killers, who had 84.5 points on the bench. Drake 21, Martin 13, Jackson 19, Moore 17, Cook 9, and the Titans 4. So, you know, this could have been anything, this game, really, with different choices, but the choices were made and Young Remix Killers got the chocolate. So just as a bit of a recap, yeah, Rock for Cash beat Team Mazza. The Browns beat Little Waiters. Archie's All-Stars beat Little River Giants. Moneymaker 7 beat the Kelpies. Shiva Kamani beat Mitch's Mongrels. And Young Remix Killers beat Smooth Criminal. So to the latter, after week 12, only 1 week to go. We have the Browns sitting on top with 10 wins and 2 losses. I can officially announce the Browns as the minor premier. They're actually probably the minor premier last week as well. Well done, King Brown Snake. It's been a really good season by the Browns, very consistent. Like I said, 10 wins, 2 losses. Well-deserved minor premier, but, you know, the rubble hit the road in a couple of weeks, so it won't mean anything unless you win the Duty Bowl, Brown. So, well done again on winning the minor premiership. In second spot, Rock for Cash have moved back into second spot with 7 wins, 5 losses. Young Remix Killers up 2 places to 7 wins and 5 losses in third. Team Mazza drops 2 spots to 4th with 7 wins and 5 losses. Archie's All-Stars up 1 spot to 7 wins and 5 losses. So we've got 4 teams on 7 wins and 5 losses. And 4 doesn't go into 3. We only have a top 4 that have the bye next week, so someone's going to miss out. The Kelpies have dropped 2 spots to 6 and 6. Little Waiters have stayed at 6 and 6 in 7th spot. Smooth Criminal spewing after this week, down at 8th spot, 5 and 7. Mitch's Mongrels again spewing, 5 and 7 as well in 9th spot. They could have been, those two teams could have been in the mix. Moneymaker 7, who's now won 2 in a row. He's moved up to 5 and 7. Is the Moneymaker making a run? Just wait and see about that one. Little River Giants, 4 and 8, lost their last 2 in 11th spot. And Shiva Kamini with a win this week, still on the bottom, 3 wins, 9 losses. But good to see the Shiva get a win this week. Well done, Nickety. Like I said, the Taco Bell this week went to Young Remix Killers. Just a quick look at week 13. We have Rock for Cash up against Smooth Criminal, Little Waiters playing Little River Giants in the Little Cup. The Brothers Cup, Team Mazza hosting Shiva Kamini. The Kelpies against Young Remix Killers. Archie's All-Stars up against Mitch's Mongrels. And Moneymaker 7 hosting the Browns. Few things to talk about. Firstly, as I mentioned in the last video, trading is now finished. There is no more trading. So The Rock can see that this week's waiver, to me, is probably the most important waiver wire of the season. It will set you up for the finals. So I would get on there if I was you. There's a lot of teams that haven't even bothered to be on the waiver this year. But I think that this week will be very, very important to a lot of teams. There's a few injuries today that Cash put on the FNFL page. They'll need to be replaced. And yeah, like I said, the waiver will be very, very interesting this week. In other news, the Cash has done a computer-generated draw. For those of you that can be bothered or even give a flying fat rat's fanny, the FNFL Cup, the cup with no name, it will be named very, very soon. The Cash has put it out there. No one's got back to him really with a name. So the Cash is just going to come up with a name in the next, hopefully by the next Cash TV. So the first game of the first semi-final of the FNFL Cup, we'll see the Browns hosting Rock for Cash, and in the other game, Team Mazza will be hosting Archie's All-Stars. So we've virtually got first versus second on the FNFL ladder and fourth versus fifth. So if that doesn't excite you, I don't know what will. Other news, not a real lot more. The Cash will try and do a bit of a eFNFL preview maybe tomorrow. He's got his preview of week 13 on Thursday, which he'll have to do or try and do from down in Geelong. He's down to Geelong on Thursday and Friday, so he'll try and do his preview whilst he's down in Geelong, maybe down the beach if I can get down to the beach, but work may stop that, so it might just be done from the hotel, we're not sure. Other than that, great round of FNFL this week. Week 12's now done and dusted. There's 1 week to go. In the Rock's eyes, there's only three teams that can make it into the top four. The Kelpies, Little Waiters, and Archie's All-Stars. Look, it's going to be interesting. The Kelpies have got Young Remix Killers. Little Waiters got Little Root of a Giants. And Archie's All-Stars got Mitch's Mongrels, and they're hoping that Team Mazza, Young Remix Killers, and Rock for Cash lose. So it's going to be really interesting. It's going to be a great round. Week 13 will start on Friday with a... Let's just see who's playing on the Friday. New Orleans Saints and the Dallas Cowboys. And it will finish up with Washington Redskins against the Philadelphia Eagles on Tuesday. So with that, guys, it's gone a little bit over the 15. Sorry, Nickity, you're going to have to get out of the car, go to work and listen to the last 4 or 5 minutes on the way home. So with that, one other thing, might be catching up with a few coaches this weekend. So we might try and get a few more interviews leading into the finals. Hopefully the Brown, Moneymaker 7, and Smooth Criminal. We'll just see how we go. Anyway, that's the Cash out.